welcome to our first virtual Vesper. Today's theme is inclusivity and diversity. So first, we're just gonna remind each other of our Vesper claps. Even though it's hard because we're not together, we can still do it at home. So
we have the shake and bake.
Favorite classic. We've got the jazz hands, the snapping.
Isn't it Kobe?
Yeah.
Kobe.
We've got the fishing rod. Wheel it in.
Keep an arrow.
So those are a few Vesper claps that you guys can do at home.
All right, so let's get started. So as Kiana mentioned, today's theme is inclusivity and diversity. So I'm gonna start with us off with a quote. "We're all different, which is great because we're all unique. Without diversity, life would be very boring."
So we just want you guys to try and focus on what it means to be diverse and be inclusive here at camp and also just in your daily lives. So now we're going to be reading a story. It's called One of Us by Peggy Moss.
Okay. Roberta James put her hair up, straight up, and walked into Baker School. She was late, 2 weeks late. "We just moved here," Roberta explained to the principal. "Welcome to Baker School," the principal said. "I think you're going to love it here."
The principal was right. Roberta loved the brightly painted walls and the library full of books. She thought the playground looked fabulous. When Roberta got to her classroom, she met Carmen. "Sit here," Carmen said. "You're one of us." Roberta sat.
At recess, Roberta ran toward the monkey bars. "We don't play on the playground," Carmen said. "We sit here and talk." Roberta smiled. "Thank you, but actually, I love the monkey bars." She met Rodney there, and Jasmine and Katie. "You're one of us," Jasmine said. "Sit with us at lunch."
At lunchtime, Roberta picked up her Daisy lunchbox and walked over to the monkey bar gang. They all had monkey lunchboxes. "Kids with flowers on their lunchboxes sit over there," Katie said. She scrunched up her face and pointed. "I wish I had a flowered lunchbox," Rodney said. "That's ridiculous," Katie said. "You're a boy."
Roberta looked at the flowered lunchbox kids. They waved. "You're one of us," Amiko said. "Come on over," Emily called. Roberta walked over. She was feeling a little confused as she sat down. "What's in there?" Amiko asked. Roberta took out her mother's famous mayonnaise and coconut pita, rolled up with raisins, stuffed into the ends. Everyone at the table stared. "Kids who eat that kind of stuff sit over there," Amiko said.
Roberta looked across the lunchroom. A group of kids eating pita roll-ups waved. "Come on over," one of them said. "You're one of us," another shouted. They were all wearing cowboy boots.
"I wear running shoes," Roberta said quietly. "I think I'd better sit right here."
"Who are you?" Anna asked. "Roberta James," Roberta said. "I mean, what are you?" Anna said.
"I'm a straight-up hair girl who climbs monkey bars and carries a flowered lunchbox with a pita roll-up in it. And I wear running shoes," Roberta said. "Oh," Anna said very slowly, "so you're one of us." "I doubt it," Roberta said. "What are you?"
"I am a trumpet-playing girl who likes baseball and car racing and ballet," Anna said.
"I like spicy food," Roberta said. "I love baseball, but I'm not crazy about ballet." "Perfect," Jason said. "But we aren't the same," Roberta said. "That's the best part," Anna said.
"How was your first day?" the principal asked as Roberta got ready to go home. "Pretty good," Roberta said. "I bet you fit right in," the principal said. Roberta giggled. "Yeah, I guess I do." The end. All in this together. Once we know that we are, we're all stars. And we see that we're all in this together. And it shows when we stand hand in hand. Make our dreams come true. Okay, so this is What Makes a Rainbow by Betty Ann Schwartz.
Little Rabbit and his mother were sitting under a big flower petal. Look, said Little Rabbit, it stopped raining. Yes, Mama Rabbit, soon we'll see a rainbow. What's a rainbow? Asked Little Rabbit. Why don't you ask your friend, said Mama Rabbit. Ladybug, what makes a rainbow? Asked Little Rabbit. Red, said Ladybug, gently closing her red wings. You need red to make a rainbow.
Mr. Fox, what makes a rainbow? Asked Little Rabbit. Orange, said Mr. Fox, swishing his orange tail. You need orange to make a rainbow.
Little Chick, what makes a rainbow? Asked Little Rabbit. Yellow, said Little Chick, fluffing her soft yellow fuzz. You need yellow to make a rainbow.
Mr. Grasshopper, what makes a rainbow? Asked Little Rabbit. Green, said Mr. Grasshopper, rubbing his long green legs together. You need green to make a rainbow.
Bluebird and Beetle, what makes a rainbow? Asked Little Rabbit. Blue, said Bluebird, ruffling her pretty blue feathers. And indigo, said Beetle, showing her shiny indigo back. You need blue and indigo to make a rainbow.
Butterfly, what makes a rainbow? Asked Little Rabbit. Purple, said Butterfly, spreading her delicate purple wings. You need purple to make a rainbow.
Well, said Mama Rabbit's Little Rabbit, now you know what makes a rainbow. Rain, colors, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, purple, and sunshine.
The end.
Hey, Cashel, what did that book mean to you?
To me, that book means that there might be a lot of components to work together to make something magical like camp or a rainbow, but just because you might not have a component like being at camp physically doesn't mean we can't still have that magic by finding other things to replace that with. Yeah. And as long as we work together, we can get that camp magic experience this summer.
Please bow your head. Dear Lord, thank you for giving us the opportunity to be inclusive here at camp. We thank you for giving us a place where everyone is welcome and where we are comfortable being ourselves. Amen.